Hello my beautiful friends and welcome back to my channel. My name is Tania Levy and I'm a voice teacher from Germany, now with my studio, stage art studio here in Singapore. I teach every day all around the world via Skype, also in person. So if you wanna get strong with your voice, learn how to kick ass and use those stage crafts into your daily life, then this is the best chance to contact me via my homepage, Tania Levy Vocal Studios. To give you educational, helpful tips that you can use to improve your voice. Thank you so much for tuning in and I'll see you in my next video.
A really interesting question is, do you really need a vocal coach? I have some tips and suggestions and let's start with the first tip. Number one, vocal health. When you are alone practicing without any certain vocal knowledge, right? About techniques, about the basics, the foundation of singing, right? You're gonna be very likely to harm and injure yourself when it comes to singing. But creating a really, really wrong breath management, breath support, right? I see a lot of kids here in my studios that still use a lot of clavicular breathing, you know, the upper chest breathing. They still are disconnected from their body. They don't understand how to properly breathe. The other important thing is when it comes to singing those high notes, if you are just a singer in the shower or, you know, a karaoke queen, you would be very likely to strain some certain notes. How can you know how to sing them right? Because you don't have a guidance, you have no one to tell you how it works technically, right? So a lot of singers tend to strain when it comes to the upper register. So I think the first and important reason why you should have a vocal coach is when you are deciding to go on your vocal journey, you're gonna sing, then it's really important that you make sure that your vocal health is on point. And for a good vocal health, you have to start to have a really solid and good healthy foundation. Number two, your vocal coach can help you to achieve your goals. So if you have a certain goal, right, like for example, you wanna be better in a certain register, you wanna learn how to work with your mixed voice, you wanna learn how to belt, you wanna learn some certain things that you would not learn with just YouTube videos, then you have a professional guide. Yeah, you have a professional singing teacher, vocal coach, voice teacher that helps you to go through all of the things you would like to achieve. These people have a lot of knowledge in their suitcase. They bring in a lot of exercises. They bring in a lot of skills to show you how to work in certain matters. Let me give you an example from my vocal journey. When I was a kid and I loved to sing, I started to sing very, very early. I didn't have so many encouraged teachers like I am now, for example. My teachers, they pass on songs to me and they never really encouraged me to sing in my head voice register. I never really, really worked on that register. Also, it was an identification problem for me because I had this really tiny voice compared to my big chest voice and it was uncomfortable and I never had this full support to work in this upper register, to work on my mixed voice belting. It was not really something that I learned at that time. And so it took me quite many, many years when I started to study and when my voice teacher in college from Essel, for example, started to work with me on belting. That was incredible. It was amazing. There was a whole world that just unfolded in front of my eyes. And all of a sudden I realized I can sing much better than I'm singing right now. Number three. And number three is one of my favorite examples, tips or guides, and it's the confidence. When I started to sing, I was very young, like I already mentioned, and I had terrible confidence. If you are a long time follower on my channel, you know about my background history, that I came from a really abusive household and I was mobbed for many, many, many years at a very difficult time. I was always overweight. I had never friends. People were literally following me after school, stealing my phones, kicking me. I had a very difficult and terrible time. When I was 12 years old, I auditioned for our school band. I was singing a song. The first one was Papa Don't Preach by Madonna, and the second one was Armageddon by Aerosmith. And that was the first time when I received a certain recognition from my surroundings, from the surroundings I were in, from people that actually always hated me, they started to, you know, be interested in me, and they suddenly respected me in a very different way. So when I started then to participate in school band, I started from singing one song, I Say a Little Prayer by Aretha Franklin, and in the next year I was singing already much, much more songs. And that just absolutely boosted my self-confidence and helped me to grow as a person, helped me to socialize better. It made me so much more confident in the way I speak, in the way I treated myself, in the way I was recognized. It was a really life-changing experience just to go and start to audition for our school band. And I continued to until I left school to sing with that band and had many songs, amazing performances. It was amazing. Number four, having knowledge in a certain profession is always giving you a freedom, right? It gives you a certain power that you have, understanding your craft and making you an expert. And if you are a singer, then you want to make sure that you understand what you're doing and that you want to reproduce what you're doing. So a lot of singers, they sometimes go on stage and they are really unsure if they can reproduce those high notes, the whistle. You know, they're not sure if they're gonna make it this time because they don't really know how their voice works, how their craft works, and what is happening anatomically, what do they have to do to make certain notes. So a lot of singers nowadays, they are really, really good, but they don't have any knowledge about their voice. They actually don't know what they're doing. Knowing what you're doing is improving your craft 130%. It's gonna make you a so much more better listener, performer, singer, songwriter. So your improvement will be not only in singing and vocal techniques, but it will be in this whole area, in this whole field. I want to add something. Can you learn something from the YouTube videos online? Yes and no. I'm not gonna lie, there are some really nice vocal coaches that teach you how to sing. It's like this, if you want to really learn the foundation of singing, it's not gonna be with a 3 or 4 minute video. It's gonna be with making a vocal journey, find the right teachers or teacher, and then, you know, practice every day and have a guide that is live, that you can talk to, you know, have a person that you can talk to, speak to. And those 3 or 4 minutes that you're seeing in a video are just 3 minutes of a 1 hour lesson, for example, right? Or of a 45 minute lesson. So yes, you will learn and progress so much better if you really do have a vocal coach in life. If you liked that video and you think it was helpful, then please give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comment section if you would like to see more kind of that videos, and I would be super happy to bring out a new series on that. Yeah, subscribe to that channel if you haven't by now. I know you're watching and you're not subscribing. Best opportunity, go for it. If you want to book a lesson with me, of course, then I will just blend in here that beautiful picture and you can just look up here. Yeah, exactly. And yeah, on tanialevyvoicepower.com, and yeah, give me a call and I see you in my next video.